This week marks the end of the Australian Marriage Law Postal Survey, a historic moment when the government asked us, the Australian people, to confirm what literally dozens of opinion polls had already told them we were all thinking.
I was thinking, there's Tony Abbott, I'm going to headbutt him.
No, that is not the right clip, and obviously we don't endorse that in any way. And also remember that Mr. Astrolabes as the headbutt wasn't even about marriage equality.
Wasn't a very effective headbutt.
See, he's fine.
Apparently I didn't get him well enough.
Are we only going to use headbutt clips? Is that it? Really? Anyway, the postal survey wraps up this week, so let's take stock of the whole thingamajig. The postal survey kicked off on the 12th of September. Since then, 16 million ballots have been sent out, which, when all is said and done, will cost us around $122 million. And current estimates say that about 80% of Australians have chosen to have their say on same-sex marriage. 80%? Really? That seems high. I really didn't think it'd be that high. Did you think it'd be that high? Well, Australian public, I'm sorry for doubting you. Turns out you know how to post a letter. Well, 4 out of 5 of you do. I was wrong to think you wouldn't vote in the survey, and I was wrong to think Australia Post couldn't handle the extra mail.
We thought letters were dead. We sold the machine that does letters to some guy in the Philippines. Now we just got Barry.
All right, that sketch was wrong, and I'm sorry. But, who was right about this being a respectful debate?
The vast majority of people have, the vast, you know, 99.999% have dealt with this issue respectfully and civilly as Australians do.
Like the Brisbane Archbishop, who said that same-sex marriage was like a parent marrying a child. Or when Yes campaigners called for this doctor to be deregistered after she appeared in a No campaign ad. Or when Eric Abetz said marriage equality could lead to people marrying the Harbour Bridge. Personally, I've always said that climbing the Harbour Bridge was a gateway behaviour to fucking the Harbour Bridge. Or when a certain Asian Australian SBS personality mused about whether he was going to hate homophobic MPs. It wasn't me.
Oh, Hing's a virgin.
I'm not a virgin, that's... Or when the head No campaigner, Lyle Shelton, came on this show and compared children of same-sex couples to the Stolen Generation in front of two Indigenous hosts. Which seems super respectful. But it's over. Congratulations, we made it. Well done, we can say goodbye to this whole toxic mess. Now it's just the grueling wait for the results, the inevitable backlash to that, and then the long and drawn out legislative process, which again, they could have done without this whole survey. But hey, I was wrong about the turnout, so maybe this will all be just super chill.